Apology from Coffee Fungos at Exploring Historic Links with Slavery. The Chief Executive of the Church Commissioners for England has apologized for the body risco, SAIPCO, Saming Irisco, links to transatlantic chattel slavery while speaking at an exhibition featuring documents and items exhibiting the historic association. Gareth most inside ILCO, no amount of money will ever be enough to repair the damage done IRSCO, through the slave trade would cut the response of the commissioners. Who manage an investment fund of more than 10 libras billion for the Church of England. Would help create ILCO, a better future for all IRSCO. It comes after a report found the fund as part of its origins in Queen Anne IRSCO, S. Bounty. Which was founded Pulgada 1704 and had links with transatlantic slavery. This prompted the church to announce 100 libras million of funding for a programme of investment. Research and engagement to treat ILCO, address pastorongs IRCO. However, there has been criticism from some groups who argue the money would be better spent funding work in local parishes. Speaking at the enslavement, voices from the archives exhibition at Lambeth Palace Library. Which opened in early January, Mr. Most Inside, ILCO, what we discovered from our research into our predecessor funds. Links to historic chattel slavery, in Shaming and IRSCO, redeeply sorry. We have announced a commitment of 100 libras million of funding in response to what we have learned. ILCO, no amount of money will ever be enough to repair the damage done through the transatlantic slave trade. ILCO, but we hope that our response will be a means of investing in a better future for all. Especially communities impacted by the legacy of the slave trade, and to create a positive, lasting legacy ILCO. Mr. Most Inside part of the Church Commissioners ILCO, response was to ILCO. Make sure that our history is told and that we IRSCO, retransparent about what we have learned IRSCO. We added that the exhibition IRSCO, is part of that transparency, part of telling the story IRSCO. IRSCO, with our report focused on financial transactions, our research has also uncovered many materially impactful documents from here in the library and we wanted to display those in the exhibition IRSCO. The display includes early 18th century letters from Queen Anne IRSCO, S. Bounty and an anonymous letter written by an enslaved person Pulgada 1723 to the ILCO, Archbishop of London IRSCO, petitioning for their freedom. A missionary book from 1808 published for enslaved and former enslaved people, edited to remove all references to freedom from slavery, will also be on display. In 2019 the Church Commissioners decided to conduct research into the source of its fund. Working with forensic accountants to review financial ledgers and other original documents from its archives. The report found that, by 1777, Queen Anne IRSCO, S. Bounty held 440 libras, 962 of South Sea Company annuities ILCO. Calculate to a bebé en Word 406 libras. 942, potencial y equivalente to around 724 libras million in today IRSCO, S. Terms, IRSCO. The report estimates the South Sea Company transported 34,000 slaves ILCO, included. Unsanitary, unsafe and inhumane conditions IRSCO, during its 30 years of operation.